Hi, this is Shop Talk. I'm Lexi Schultz sitting in for Ria Tanhuatco Trillo. It's a brand new year, but money-wise, there may be nothing new with your situation. So to help you improve in your fiscal standing, we have our favorite money doctor with us today, Joe Ferreria.
Yeah.
He's the president of Moneydoctors Incorporated. Joe will share with us his top money resolutions for 2012. Hi, Joe.
Hi, Lexi.
I'm glad that it's you today. Because, you know, it's January.
Yeah.
Of course, just coming out of the Christmas holiday. Mm. I don't know about you, but I feel broke.
Yeah, most people have buyer's remorse in January, you know. They always tell themselves, I will not spend as much in December, but they end up overspending.
Buyer's remorse, I like that.
Yeah. So you start with one you want to give family, and then before you know it, you have a big pool of people that you need to give to. And then
right.
you start go to, who will I give in the office? Before you know it, everybody gets a gift from you in the office. So January, you always say, I will never do this again next year. But it happens.
It always happens. But Money Talk is with you throughout the year. Let's
yes.
talk about Money Doctors really briefly before we talk about our money resolutions.
Money Doctors is one of the only firm that really handles personal finance. We try to teach people how to handle money properly. That's the first one. Second is we try to make people, give financial education to people so that they become investors. Okay, because most common, people would put their money only in the banks. They mm-hmm. never get into the stock market.
It's the safest thing, though, to put
yes,
your money in the bank.
Yes, safe, small return.
Of course.
So you've got to be a little bit more educated in the other areas to improve the passive income.
And do you find that come January, you have a lot more people knocking on your door saying, oh, I need help, because
oh, yeah.
they obviously feel like they're a lot...
Yeah, I think people have a feeling of losing a sense of control over their finances. For 11 months, they're able to budget and try to hold down the expenses properly. And then in December, of course, the holiday season really takes over.
Right.
And you go into a frenzy of buying stuff that you never saw before during the year.
Yes,
of Seems
course.
Like everybody brings the nicest stuff in December.
Okay.
So how can you resist that?
Well, this is why we're here now with money resolutions.
Yep.
So you have a whole list for me. Let's go through the first one.
Well,
live simply.
Yeah, because...
that sounds like common sense, but it's difficult to do.
It is kind of difficult for some people, because when I talk to people and I look at their expenses, I tell them, you have to categorize it into two kinds, or even three. One is, what would be the expenses that you need to survive? Obviously, if
so
you
need.
Yeah, need. Mm-mm. If you don't pay the electricity, they turn it off.
Correct.
Okay, what are the lifestyle expenses? The cell phone is a lifestyle expense. People tell me, I cannot live without my cell phone.
That's a necessary one, though.
Really?
I think so, for
you,
work.
You wear a cell phone, there's a landline. People communicated with one another. But what I'm really saying is, because it's a lifestyle expense, you need to learn to manage it properly. And
okay.
business expenses would be, you go to the office every day, you pay for gas or even transportation money. You need to understand where you're spending more money. And the thing is, you need to cut back more on lifestyle expenses. Because survival expenses, you
need.
You need it. Mm. No? But lifestyle expenses, that's where you really need to cut back and live more simply.
Okay. Well, that's difficult, but we'll try.
Yeah. People can do it.
Of course. But you have to also categorize what exactly is want and need.
Understanding where you're spending your money is the first key to living simply.
Okay.
Where does it really go? Do you measure it? If you don't measure it, how can you manage it?
Right.
Yeah, so that's what it is. Just go to the provinces and look at people there. They can survive with 10,000 pesos a month.
That is true.
Why?
Because they live simply.
Yeah, they live simply.
And speaking of not knowing where money goes, you have to manage your debt better.
Yes. Using your credit card is not availing of free money. It needs to be paid.
Feels like that sometimes, doesn't it?
Yeah. You know, when you borrow money from the bank, it's our responsibility to pay it back. The
of
sooner
course.
You pay it back, the better. The better managed clients I have are those that really are convenience users. They use a card. Of course, they cannot bring along with them a ton of money when they buy things. But they pay it back. When the bill comes, they pay all of it. Or at worst, pay it over 3 months or 6 months. Never allow the
with
next...
With minimal interest, I suppose.
Yeah, never allow the next Christmas season to come. And then you still have that Christmas debt.
Do people exist like that?
But there are people.
Joe?
Like that. Yes, there are.
Wow. And you were saying a while ago that people borrow money also during the holidays because I guess...
Oh, yeah. It's a natural... It's a cultural trait of the Filipino. We want to please everybody, you know. If you give a gift to an auntie, will the other auntie feel bad? So you have to buy another gift for the other auntie. And we have extended families. We never run out of aunties, nephews, nieces, and
That's
friends.
That's true. So but what's your main tip on borrowing? Because sometimes it's a necessity to do as well.
Make
whether
sure that
it be
you
for, you know, the particulars. Like, let's say you really can't pay electricity this month for some reason. You need to borrow money in that respect.
Yeah, but try to manage it to a point where you can easily pay it. Like, for example, if you're paying 10% of your income for your debts, that's very comfortable to do. But if you're paying 70% of your income or even 50% towards debts, it becomes very tiresome to work. You work for paying your credit card.
Right. Well, we're talking percentages now. Your third resolution is you have to save 30% of your income.
Oh, yes.
That's a lot.
Yes.
That sounds like a lot.
Actually, that's not a lot because the Singaporeans are known to save 70%.
70% each month?
Yeah. You wonder where they put all that money. But the Japanese save 50%. And look at these countries. They're very progressive. Why? Because when you see an opportunity come before you, you need money to take advantage of it.
And with us now, what do you think we do at 10% or even less?
Surprisingly, 10 years ago, I would, even say that people don't know how to save money. But today, I see the younger people becoming more aware of saving money. I have some people in my portfolio who spend only 50% and save the rest.
Wow.
Yeah. In fact, some of them can even retire at 52.
I need to learn from these people.
Living simply, not borrowing too much, and
True.
Saving money. And more important, investing your money.
Okay, so the fourth one, get a financial education. People shy away from this sometimes.
Yeah, because if you want to invest in bonds or stocks or in mutual funds, you need to understand what it is all about. Okay, you need to see the inner workings of that. That's, to me, a very critical part of our work. If you say that you want to buy bonds, sure, but understand how it works.
But isn't that what the financial advisor is for?
Yes, that's what we're paid to do. We're paid to teach people all about these financial products. If you walk in Hong Kong, you will see high school kids looking at the stock market billboard. Even the old people are watching the stock market. Why is that? Why don't I see that in Manila? Because we don't have the financial education. And because you don't try to get it. As ordinary citizens, we should try to get a financial education. It's not as complex as you think. You don't need to be a mathematician to understand it. The stock market is really buying and selling. Buying at what price and selling at a higher price and knowing when to buy and then to sell.
But how long does it take for someone to be comfortable enough to be able to do that on their own?
I think 3 months would be good.
3 months?
Yeah, I've had some experiences with doctors, for example, who always tell themselves, I'm very poor in math. Okay. I have a doctor in a hospital here in Global City. He's doing 15% in the stock market. I mean, he told me he's not good in math. And here he is, he's making money in the stock market, Not 15% all the time, but he makes money out of the stock market. That's the point, whether it's 1%, 3%, or 10%. He's making money, so less than 3 months, he knows how to do it.
Well, he's investing wisely then, which
yes.
is your fifth resolution.
Yeah, invest tip. Wisely means not put all your money in one basket only, but rather spread it over several instruments. I think this year, in 2012, we'll be headed towards better times. If you know how to read the economic indicators, it all points towards that. And if you have money, this is the best time to save it and then invest it. Because you invest heavily during good years. Okay, and you invest more cautious manner during down years. So we've been through a down year in 2010, in 2011, and 2012 should be a good one.
So you see everything going well, the stock market,
yeah.
businesses in general,
yeah.
people who want to get into smaller businesses, would you suggest that people do that?
Yes, especially for the OFW market. Sometimes when you work overseas, the first thing you want to do is buy a house. Okay, I'm with you on that one, buy a house. But I always tell them, I always ask them, when will you stay home? Okay, so you're there for 5 years, you tell yourself you live for overseas, in the airport you tell your family this is for 5 years. After that, you're still there 10 years later because you don't know how to invest your money in an enterprise which will provide more money in the future.
Okay. Well, I like doing these segments because you learn a lot.
yeah.
As a layperson who's not very good with numbers, you get intimidated, but
Yeah, it's not.
Layman's
if you know
terms.
How to add 1 + 1, you should be good.
Not naman, Joe.
Yeah.
Well, we have more money resolutions after this break, so keep it here. Shop Talk will be right back.